their energy. It's also their, you know, like, yeah, you say, oh, you know, like, what rock band's not getting on stage with energy? Okay, you know, there are plenty, you know, you better, because, you know, you got to put your energy, the energy goes into, you know, you can play guitar, and then you can make that guitar, you know, say something and scream something, and like, you know, what are you going to do with that guitar, that bass, that drum, you know, what kind of, how much of you, your soul, your blood, sweat, whatever, your sweat and your tears or whatever, it's going to go and into that. That's going to, and that's who they were. That's who the Who were. Oh, is it me? Yeah, sorry.
It's all on you, man.
Here we go.
It's all on, wait, you.
Me?
My finger's kind of swollen.
Get the finger out of there. Oh, wait, we're on camera. Hi, everyone. Welcome to another episode of Into the Music. My name's Greg. And that guy over there.
I can introduce myself.
You ruined it. All right, Chris. Hi, Chris. What do you got for me tonight?
All right. I've got, I know you know this band. They're called The Who.
And The Who?
The Who. Now, you might know this song, but maybe not this version. It's The Magic Bus. It's from Live at Leeds, so it's a live version. And I have a lot to say about it, but I will wait till I see you on the other side of the reaction.
All right. Now, I mean, I'm being serious here. I mean, if I was to say Live at Leeds, okay, that's interesting. I mean, you know, I've heard of their concert stuff at Leeds. I just haven't checked it out. You know, I just haven't.
You haven't checked out anything from Live at Leeds?
I have. Well, I mean, when I say check out, I mean, like, sit there and like listen and
really pay attention.
But I've seen, yeah, you know, I think that In Twistle has the bone thing. I've definitely seen that. I've seen whatever. I think that's the concert. Let's see if I'm wrong. I'll go and check it out. But no, I have not heard this song, you know, from that concert. So good choice, man. Let me go check it out.
All right.
Magic Bus. Takes me to you.
In Twistle was wearing that skeleton outfit. Yeah, I had seen footage, whatever, with him wearing it. Interesting.
Too much magic bus. I try my baby every way. Too much magic bus. So I would never really associate the music genre of like funk to the Who, but this is funky. I mean, this is just, it's got such a good groove, and just a real vibe, you know? This is great. Yeah. I don't know why I never actually really sat down and watched, you know, the Who's performance at this concert. It's pretty classic, you know? It's legend. So glad I'm watching it now.
Bye. Okay. You can have the magic bus for 100 English pounds. No! Too much. Give me 100!
That's a nice change up. I'm gonna bring that back just a little bit. Yeah, that was a nice change up. It was going crazy, and then all of a sudden we're like, oh, okay. We're back in line again. Daltrey's look back then in the 70s, quintessential rocker, you know? I mean, that's the long flowing hair, the curly locks. He's got like the threads.
So definitely. So Entwistle had this, he had a skeleton outfit. You know, what the hell was he thinking when he wore that?
I was wondering what you, I didn't catch exactly what you said when we were doing the introduction.
Oh yeah.
So yeah, yeah, right.
It was the bones and all like that, you know, I was like, yes, that's the one. So yeah, no, but I hadn't, you know, and I've seen some footage, you know, and, you know, some of the songs at that time, you know, before they created all the other great stuff after that, I think what that was 71. I think that concert was recorded
1970.
Wow.
Yeah.
And that song, I like that song. I've always liked that song. I don't love that song, but they took that song and they just like, they rocked that.
I like the studio. I like the studio version a lot, and I like this live version a lot.
Yeah.
So, and they're very different. This one is really, the guitar is so heavy. The electric guitar is so heavy.
Here's the thing. It's very hit and miss for me, early Who. Okay. Uh-huh. It's when they get into their later stuff, but their early stuff is hit and miss. Now, this is not a miss. This song, the studio version is not a miss. It's, I don't know if it was a hit. I think it was like a nice tap. You know, it's just a song that, you know, I like, you know, and I don't shut off if it's on the radio, you know. Right. It's not one of those where they play it over and over and over again. You know, it's got that cool kind of funky beat, whatever. It's quirky and stuff like that. So that's really good. You know, Magic Bus, you know, I want it. So, I mean, it's a good song. But what they did in the concert, they just they made it like a rock song. You know, I just don't know. I never really thought of it as a rock song. You know, in the studio version, I mean, it's by a rock band, but it was never rock.
Well, right.
This was rock. This was rock. They were putting, you know, Moon was putting the drums, you know, and Townsend was just doing these cool licks on the guitar and stuff. It was really good. It was, and Adultery was just being Mr. Rockstar himself, you know, as he usually is, you know, with the tassels, you know, and the curly locks and stuff like blowing down, you know, I mean, he's the quintessential, you know, rock star right on the stage. Mm-hmm. And they just rocked the hell out of it. It was really, really good. It was good listen, great listen, you know, and just a really great choice. Yeah.
And let me run down I'm really glad to hear that. Yep. I knew it though. I knew you'd feel that
you
way.
You know me. It. You know me so well.
I know you. I do. But let me just want to go over the personnel. The configuration of the band back then was Pete Townsend on guitar, and Pete Townsend is also, God, what did you write? 100% of their songs, or close to it.
Just about.
Roger.
And Twistle did a little bit, but yeah.
Yeah, right.
Like 99%.
99%, yeah, it was Pete Townsend. And Roger Daltrey was a singer. And John Entwistle on bass. And Keith Moon, fantastic drummer, was on, drums. So they were quite a band. And, you know, when you think about it, instrumental, well, other than playing the harmonica with that Daltrey did,
yeah,
basically a three-piece band as far as the instrumentation goes.
Yeah.
So they really put out a lot. They for a live show, they really put out a lot of, that was a lot of sound for
it was
a few instruments, and they just kicked it, man. It's just fantastic.
Yeah,
I love it.
Yeah, that's a really good point.
And the little runs and the just everything Townsend was doing on the guitar. Because they spaced it out, you know, so that there was all this space for Pete Townsend to just do his thing on guitar. And, you know, we've talked about this before where, you know, there's an underrated guitarist. Although so many people say that now, that is he underrated, really? Because we all know he's underrated.
Right.
But he's just a fantastic guitar player.
And, no, he really
it,
is.
It shows in this one.
Yeah. I mean, I was writing some notes down like I always do, and like, yeah, I mean, nothing profound. You know, Townsend's guitar sounded great. Amped. That's what I wrote down. But, but you know, when you, because you made a really good point about the three-person band, you know, coming up, producing that sound, you know. And I think that, you know, they definitely made sure they had the right amps, you know, stacked and everything. And just,
and plus John Entwistle on bass, that fills in a lot.
Entwistle's bass, absolutely. Yeah. I mean, John Entwistle, one of the greatest bass players of all time. Okay. Telling you right now, everyone. But you know what? I was thinking too, like, it's the energy. it's also that, you know, like, oh, yeah, absolutely. You say, oh, you know, like, what rock band's not getting on stage with energy? Okay, you know, there are plenty, you know, you better, because, you know, you got to put your energy, the energy goes into, you know, you can play guitar, and then you can make that guitar, you know, say something and scream something, and like, you know, what are you going to do with that guitar, that bass, that drum, you know, what kind of, how much of you, your soul, your blood, sweat, whatever, your sweat and your tears or whatever, it's going to go and into that. That's going to, and that's who they were. That's who the Who were, you know, they were just full of energy.
The physicality of it all.
Yeah. The physicality. Yeah. Alpha males, you know, which I'm not saying that that's I'm not saying, you know, I'm making a judgment, but alpha males are the great. I'm just saying this energy just boom, coming right out. And, you know, I mean, Keith Moon, I mean, when you have a drummer like that, who, you know, he was from a different planet.
You had four people there who were just top notch in what they did. It just fantastic.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm glad you hadn't heard this before. I really am.
And Daltrey, again.
But well, yeah, as the vocalist. Yes, of course.
I mean, but, you know, I think, you know, I guess back in his day, he got his due. I just wonder now, you know, when people talk about the great bands, you know, Zeppelin comes up and the Beatles and all like that, you know, and the Who, but I think when people talk about the Who, they talk about, you know, Townsend and Keith Moon, you know, because I just wonder how much people really appreciate, you know, Roger Daltrey, you know, as the front man. You know, the leads, because he had some voice. And there's actually a song that, so they put an album out a year ago, and there's a song that I want you to listen to from that album. Okay. And I think he's in his 70s now. And I'm like, you know, I can't wait for you to listen to the song. I think I actually said it, the name of the song. You said no. So I think we have a shot here. And his voice is so good. So, So anyway, but this performance, this was, I got to listen to more now. I got to like sit down now and listen, because I'm sure they did a whole set of songs, right, at this Leeds concert, or was it just a couple songs?
No, it was a bunch of songs. And, there's also different versions that came out over the years where they added some tracks that weren't included in the in the original.
Okay.
I don't know how many shows they did there. I don't know if it was based on one show, multiple shows or not.
There might have been more shows. Yeah. I don't know.
Don't listen to anything yet. Okay.
I'm not.
I kind of want you to listen to at least one other song from there.
That's cool. And can we ask the audience, that Who fans out there, maybe they have some favorite Leeds stuff, and they might be, hey, forget the Leeds, you know, there's like, they did this concert back in 74. You got to listen to this. So you know,
and just, you know,
let us know.
Just want to let you know that, you know, we try to get to the requests and suggestions.
Yeah.
But due to the volume, it might take a while to get to them, or we might not get to it, but we try to be respectful of our viewers. And help, you know, we like the fact that you help guide us, you know, so inform us of what to do next. So,
right.
Don't take it personally if we don't do it, but we're trying in good faith.
And what's cool too is that not only are you just saying, hey, listen to this song, that, you know, a lot of you are also like filling us in. You're giving us information about the bands, you know, about the songs that we'll listen to. You know, did you know that they actually tried this and they put this?
Yeah, we do appreciate all the.
We really appreciate that information. Thanks for filling the blanks. That really helps.
So, all right. Anything else to add?
No, just just more live Who. So bring it on.
All right.
Cool.
So thanks for watching. Give us a like if you like this, and of course subscribe if you haven't. Yeah. And this is great, and we'll see you on the next episode of Into the Music.
See ya.